2024年诺贝尔经济学奖是由研究社会制度如何影响国家繁荣的美国三位学者，分别是麻省理工学院的教授艾塞莫鲁跟强生，以及芝加哥大学的教授罗森宾共享殊荣。他们指出了包容性社会才是引导国家走向长期经济繁荣的关键。
This belief, I think, I was sleeping with my phone off, so my wife woke me up and said, "You have to get up." You have to get up. I said, what for? She said, you've won the Nobel Prize. I thought she was kidding.
扰人清梦的正是获奖消息。美国芝加哥大学教授罗宾森与共事30年的美国麻省理工学院教授艾瑟莫鲁、强生三人一起以《制度影响国家繁荣》研究拿下今年诺贝尔经济学奖殊荣。其中最经典的例子莫过于南北韩。
In fact, South Korea versus North Korea contrast is at the very beginning of the book because it beautifully illustrates the role of institutions, the South and the North. South Korean economy picked up speed after democratization and did so in a more healthy way. But right now, South Korea is still dominated by large corporations, which brings some benefits and some costs. And I don't hold very great hope for North Korea. Its system is cemented, at least for now.And the advice to North Korea, well, who is the advice going to go to? I think one of the emphasis of our work has been, look, institutions are bad because they serve certain people's interests.
他们的研究结果指出，包容性社会制度通常能让国家走向长期繁荣。至于掠夺性社会制度，只是服务既得利益者。罗宾森甚至也拿台湾和中国做比较，指出台湾算是转型成功的例子，并对中国能在压迫性政治体制下维持经济繁荣画上大问号。但是现实世界却是他们研究中最不想看到的。
Oh, I'm not confident at all. I mean, I think if you look at data, and I've actually written about this, support for democracy is at an all-time low, especially in the U.S., but also in Greece, in the U.K., in France. I think that is a symbol of how people are disappointed with democracy.
艾斯莫鲁直叹，当前世界对民主的支持已经降到最低，反映自身研究的结论恐怕对经济造成影响。记者庄心莲、林佳莹综合报道。